The gang will have been passed information by an inside man as to where and how much cash is available. It's only then, after all this intelligence gathering, that the criminals will finally go to the house of their target.
I think the word picture we should have in our mind, which isn't a very pleasant one, and you think yourself sitting at home maybe on a Sunday night, you're relaxing, you've had a nice social weekend after you're planning to go to work the following morning, you're sitting around the television discussing sport or whatever, and your back door, your front door busts in, and you can visualize maybe three or four hooded individuals carrying guns, screaming at you and your family, bad language, using physical violence, knocking you to the floor, binding your hands, gagging you, blindfolding you, taking your children, taking them into a separate room of the house, taking your wife or your partner to another room, and then basically telling you that they want you to do exactly what's required of you, and if you don't, you'll never see your loved ones again in that state.
After holding the family overnight, the key holder's loved ones are then taken to another location. The manager is then told to go to work as normal and follow instructions. These instructions are usually very simple. To clear out as much money as possible from the company's vaults and bring it to a pre-arranged location.
You've got a classic choice at that stage, a very difficult choice, which is whether are you going to alert your colleagues or are you going to alert the police to what's happening. And that's the basic dilemma that is a very difficult question. Practically all financial institutions now very wisely have adopted very good fail-safe measures in terms of protecting the money and protecting the location. So it is impossible for any individual, be they a key holder or otherwise, to normally get their hands on very significant amounts of money. Certainly they won't be able to do it instantaneously.
The number of successful kidnappings has shown that sometimes the criminals do manage to convince their captive to follow instructions. Amounts vary from 100,000 euro to the most infamous Tiger Raid, the Northern Bank robbery in Belfast, in which £26 million was stolen.